Hi everyone, welcome back to GameMaker Cast. It's Mickey, and in this video tutorial, we're going to be going over some of the filters and effects that we have access to, even if you're locked out of the filters and effects button because you're a perpetual license user. So let's roll the introduction and let's get right into it. So you probably already found out if you were trying to make your game and you saw this new button that you maybe couldn't click it. And that's because you may have a perpetual license or you are a free user. However, that means that we can't use the filters and effects, but what we can use is we can use a extremely awesome free plugin to do the same thing. So let's actually open up a website. And the website that we're going to open up is through itch.io. It's by the author said30, so huge shout out to whoever they are. But basically, they have gone ahead and created a bunch of different effects and filters that kind of already exist in the filters and effects demo that was put out by Yo-Yo Games and for anyone who has subscribed. So let's actually take a look at what this is. So let's download this package. Now I've already downloaded it, so we'll switch back to GameMaker and let's go up to Tools and say Import Local Package. And let's go ahead and import it. So to import the package, we have the free the filters folder here, and there's a bunch of stuff in here, but let's grab the animation curves, the objects, the scripts, the shaders, and the sprites, and then say import. Now everything will be imported underneath the folder here, and it's actually really easy to use. So my game is set up with a background, which is the different colors here. We have the instances, which is all the smiley faces, and then we have the assets, which is the logo and the text. So let's say I wanted to just do the background. What you would do if you were a subscriber is you would click on this new layer and then you could do the effect or filter there. But what we're going to do is we're going to create a new instance layer, and let's go into the objects and go into children, and we have all these different effects here. For instance, if we wanted to pixelate, let's just drag and drop it into the instance too. If we actually double click on the object and we go to variable definitions here, you can see that we are able to update this just like you would in the room properties here. I'll leave everything the same and I will just hit F5 to see how this works. Now, one thing you will notice that it needs to compile the shaders, but once it's done, we have our game up and running. Now, the objects aren't pixelated, the words, the logo. However, if you look at the background, it is pixelated. So this means that we can come in and we could change the pixelation. Let's make this something kind of crazy. And if we hit F5, it's only going to pixelate that particular background. So what we could do is we could actually take this up and we could say, okay, I want to pixelate my background and all the smiley faces. So now when we run this, it's automatically going to change, and you can see that, well, my smiley face has disappeared because we pixelated too much here. Let's go back down. We'll change this back to 4. And if we hit F5, both those layers will be pixelated. Now, we can also add multiple effects onto it. So let's say we take this off. We're going to delete that and let's add the underwater effect. So we'll have the underwater effect for the objects and also the background, but let's also add a new layer and let's put on the colorize as well. So in colorize, we're going to open this up and go to variables and let's choose to make the color a nice blue color. And now if I hit F5, the two layers will have a nice blue tinge, and you can see that they are kind of wavy. So this is actually a pretty awesome system, and we are able just to kind of do what we want here, and we can just continuously add on the effects. Of course, what you could do is you could just have it go over top of everything. So when we hit F5, this will be over the background, the objects, and the words. So I highly recommend checking this out. It's pretty awesome. I will leave the link in the description below. And don't forget, give a shout out to said30 who made this. So thanks for watching. Thanks for watching the video. A special shout out to the following users on Patreon: Ian, Annie, Paul, Alex, Victor, Timothy, Thrice-Sight, Ashby, Robert, and Edward. Once again, thank you for watching the video. Please leave any feedback, hit that like button, and don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video.